Gemini. Thank you so much for coming to your weekly love reading. This love reading is for June 23rd through June 29th. This should resonate for Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. Those of you that are cross-watching, welcome, welcome. This can be your situation or your partner's. It kind of just depends. Also, too, if you haven't already, please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell if you want to receive alerts for when I book my readings. Also, too, please feel free to comment. Something that Pink Pineapple Tarot and I were talking about the other day is like how amazing it is that if you're going through something that's really fucked up and you see like there's other people going through it too, like it sucks for everybody, but at least, you know, that's somebody that you can relate to and know that it's not just you. So with that being said, if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, you always can do so by checking out my website, aaftarot.com. or simply by clicking on the link in the description. And with that being said, Gemini, let's go ahead and hop into your reading. Gemini, Gemini. Also, too, welcome to Mercury Retrograde. You already know what that means for us. Yo, first of all, the goddamn lovers just popped up. Hi. Yo, I'm here for it. Yes. Bring them back. Bring them back. With the change, the Wheel of Fortune. Bring that ass on over here. Wasn't there like some funny ass song about that or some movie? I don't know. Okay. Anyways, I'm done being a weirdo. All right, let's go ahead and hop into your reading. Who's Gemini's person of interest romantically? Who's Gemini thinking about when they're watching this reading? Okay, strength card. You can be dealing with a Leo. How does Gemini feel about their person of interest? Four of Cups. You're over here like, listen, you're taking way too fucking long. I'm over here looking all fresh. This is Moon in Cancer. I know you want me. What the fuck is going on over here? I'm tired of waiting for you. Okay, sorry. Let's see. What is the current issue or situation with Gemini and their person of interest? Okay, the Queen of Pentacles, Capricorn, or Cancer. This can be Cancer secondary, so maybe Cancer Moon, Cancer Rising, Cancer Venus. What is the current issue, or what's the current block or external influence? The Moon, Pisces, or Cancer, or something that's obviously being hidden from you? Gonna be honest. What is the best potential outcome here for Gemini and their person of interest romantically for this week? What's this week's outcome? Romantically for Gemini and the person of interest. Ooh, the Four of Wands wanted to hop out. There's like good, ooh, yes. Okay, Two of Wands with the Magician. So this is Aries. First of all, this is Aries. Some of you may be dealing with an Aries. This is also Virgo, Gemini, or Aries as well. You know, it's crazy. I feel like this week, Gemini, good things are happening. Top of the deck is the Sun. Bottom of the deck is the All Gifted. So I just want to kind of like throw that out there. You know, I definitely feel like your person, whoever you're interested in, this is somebody who's definitely a leader. This is somebody who has the ability to stand alone. I feel like, you know, Leo energy is coming in very strongly, but that could be because they're very independent, creative, original, ambitious, determined, very self-assured. Like they ooze confidence, right? Like your person of interest has a certain swag to their walk. Like my dad would always tell me, like, you can always tell a stud by how they walk, just watch. And I feel like the person that you're into or your person definitely has a little, like, you know, oomph in their step, right? They know they're the shit. They look good, they smell good, and they're fine, okay? And they have that like level of confidence. Sometimes this person can come off as arrogant or impatient, or sometimes self-centered, especially when they want something. However, this person usually will take the lead with love, and they're willing to experience anything that is new, right? And I think that something that is noted is that they can get bored at times. So usually, you know, you may have met this person while maybe on social media, okay, or like Instagram, Facebook, on a dating site. This is somewhere where maybe you had a level of self-expression and you've caught their eye or they caught your eye. Definitely you could have met them at a party or an event, or maybe like I said already, you know, with whatever you're doing. Let's scoot these over a little bit. Sorry, hopefully. Maybe not. Jesus, look, I'm a mess. I'm over here trying to move everything. You guys are like, stop touching it. Okay. Can you give me more information on the strength card here? With the Ace of Cups. Okay, I feel like your person is struggling right now. It's like they're trying their hardest not to accept your love offer or not to offer you any love. I definitely feel like for whatever reason, you know, they're really trying to fight their feelings for you. Why? Because of the Nine of Pentacles. You know, this is Venus in Virgo. Maybe this is somebody who's really trying to get their money right first. Okay, or maybe they view you as the Nine of Pentacles. So until they have enough to offer you, Gemini, they're not willing to approach you in that type of way. Like they know that they still are in the process of getting their financials or their finances, you know, in order where they're not robbing Peter to pay Paul or leaving paycheck to paycheck. And they're just trying to get everything worked out before approaching you on that type of level. More information about their person of interest. Possibly may have a Libra moon. You and this person may have gone through a level of hurt. They also may be a Pisces or like an Aquarius cusp. I don't know why I said Aquarius cusp, but that's Mars in Pisces. So, you know, I think that this person knows that when you and them are together, it feels amazing. Like they're very optimistic about you, and there is a level of aggression and desire because of how happy you make them. And I think that as much as they've tried to walk away or move away from this situation between you and them, Gemini, they can't. Because those of you that have like cross watchers, you can admit, you know, once you have a Gemini, it's hard to like shake them. And I'm not just saying that because I'm a Gemini, but you know, friends that I have that are Geminis, like for the most part, like we're pretty chill. And I don't know. Now, Gemini men, that's a whole different story. No, I'm just playing. But still, like, we have a lot to offer and we're very honest, right? Okay, so one card here for Gemini's person of interest. Okay, Six of Wands. They may be at a distance from you. This is also Leo, Jupiter and Leo. You know, they may be trying to really work on themselves right now. This person may be somebody who's seen in the media or seen different places, right? Where it's kind of hard to get a hold of them. They may be in the public eye. That's definitely coming in here strongly. They may be, you know, with music or be involved in music, I should say. Also something too, if you guys are at a distance, I feel like this person wants to come close to you. They want to touch you. It's like, they want to, I'm sorry for those of you guys that are like, oh my God, here we go. Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, more so Gemini. I feel like they want to really take control of you and have a level of domination. And I think that that's in a very sexual fashion for whatever reason. Yeah, Ace of Wands. Like they want to have sex with you. They want to touch you. They want to have that level of passion. They're tired of being at far from you, right? The Wheel of Fortune, possibly Sagittarius. They want that change, right? They want to have that conversation where you and this person travel to one another to see each other, right? Or even if you guys are not at a distance, it's also too, and this is Aquarius and Pisces, it's also too, you know, I don't know, having phone sex or having some type of like, Vicky just said, you know. Oh, so Steve Libby, he also has a YouTube channel that he reads cards to. He said that he likes when we do the you know. So Steve, here's your you know. You're welcome. Anyways, I do think that this person is in deep thought about you and fantasizing about you heavy, and they're ready just to like leave and come see you. Like they're tired of waiting. Now, how you feel about them is the Four of Cups. I think for you, it's hard because you want them and you sense that they want you too. So you're over here like, oh my God, do you not see that I'm completely bronzed up? Listen, I got glitter on my titties, okay? My hair is pulled back and it's looking fly. And now I'm just waiting for you to come over here and make some type of offer, right? It's like, I feel like we're tired of waiting. We're like, what more do you want from me? Jesus, like, you know, you're tired of being rejected. Maybe you feel rejected by this person. Maybe you feel like this person is scared of how they feel about you. You know, it's definitely you're trying to proceed very cautiously, I feel like, Gemini. Chariot, because I think that you do want to see them. It's like you get frustrated when there's not solid plans on where this is going, and that's Cancer. Where does Gemini went? That's why I think it's at a distance. That just shot out. Empress, okay. Libra or Taurus. You know, I just think for you, Gemini, like you want to feel feminine. Like you want to feel touched. You want to be heard. You want to, you know, really get in touch with like your primal instincts. You want to grow with this person, have a family with this person. And I think that you see this person as somebody that you can have that with. Look, Two of Cups, Cancer, Venus, or this is Pisces or Gemini with the Six of Cups. I think that this is a relationship or this is a connection with this person that you've probably had for, you know, lifetimes, right? This is a soul connection between you and this person. Also, Scorpio is coming up. Okay, what does Gemini like about their person of interest romantically? The Lovers, you're like, Whitney, I'm fucking in love with them. What else do you want from me? I think that they match you. I think also too, Gemini, something that you really like about this person is they let you be you. Like how many times have we been in relationships where people try to control us or they try to like dim down our light? They're like, no, you're too bright. You need to sit your ass down, right? I also think you like the fact of how nurturing and caring they are. I think that this is somebody who calls you and says, hey, have you eaten lunch? Hey, how's it going? Hey, how are the kids? Hey, what's new? Right? They're providing a level of security and a level of nurturing that I think that you need for your emotional stability, right? And I always look at the Queen of Cups as Cancer. I know it can be Scorpio or Pisces. However, for me, Cancer comes in strongly here. But it's like you enjoy that nurturing aspect that they have where they're concerned. They want the best for you. Yeah, they do. You know, Ten of Pentacles. I also feel like this is somebody that you want to settle down with. That's Virgo. This is somebody that you've thought hard and long about. I mean, that sounded like a legit, you know, sex story or porno right there. But, you know, I mean, this is definitely something that is coming to a conclusion and transforming. You know that there's something more coming, especially with the Fool here. You're like, what? Something else is coming. This isn't it. Michael Jackson, this is it. Those of you, that's for somebody that knows what I'm talking about. Okay, so what is the, what does Gemini not like about this person romantically? The Five of Cups reversed. Huh, that's kind of interesting. Maybe they don't feel guilty for making you wait. Maybe that's why you're pissed. Because why is the Five of Cups reversed here for why Gemini? With the Nine of... Let's see. Wait. Why is the Five of Cups reversed? Why don't they like the fact that they're not guilty? Or that you feel like they don't feel bad? King of Cups. Scorpio or Leo? Pisces too, right? Cancer. Okay. You know, you cannot like the fact that this person isn't showing that they're hurt, like isn't showing like any emotion, like maybe this person is hiding or holding back, withholding emotions about how they feel about you. Like they're not communicating that. They're trying to keep a very even keel. They're really trying to hide it. Why though? Why are they trying to hide their emotions from Gemini? You know, I'm hella nosy. I'm sorry. Hold on one more time. Let me focus before I go off on a tangent. Why are they hiding their... Jesus Christ. Because of the Emperor. They may be an Aries. Because for them, the moment that they tell you how they feel, they lose complete power. Right? They're powerless. The moment they feel like you know exactly how they feel about you, how strongly they feel about you, it's like, fuck, they've won. Now they've shown their hand, right? All right, Queen of Pentacles is the issue. How does Gemini feel about this Queen of Pentacles? Prince of Cups. So this is Capricorn or it's Cancer, and this can be Cancer, Moon, Rising, or Venus. You know, it can be the fact that this person, maybe like somebody's not investing as much. Maybe, you know, there's something very solid here, and it can be because of a financial situation, but it's also like seeking or requiring a level of love, right? It can't just be super, you know, emotionally detached. Because for you, how you feel about it is the Prince of Cups. And that's Pisces or Gemini. So I think for you, it's like something is very challenging here. It's like, yeah, you want to come off that you're very stable and all that, and that you don't have the emotions to back it. But in reality, you do. And look, and now that's in between the King of Cups or the King of Pentacles, Taurus or Leo. Why are you showing, how does Gemini feel about the King and Queen together? The Devil. Hold on here. Hold on. Before we get our like panties in a bunch, those of us that wear panties, let's go ahead and like figure out, is the Devil a good thing? Like, is this some freak nasty stuff? Is this us being attached to them? Or is this just some fuck shit? What's the energy of the Devil between the King and the Queen of Pentacles? The Ace of Wands. Okay, that's a sexual energy. Okay, so here's how I'm looking at the situation. One, you have the Queen of Pentacles, okay? She's over here always giving, okay? And how you feel is you're tired, maybe, Gemini, of being the one that's always trying to give, always trying to start something, always being very consistent, and you want a level of love that's offered. You want a communication on how this person feels about you emotionally, okay? Then all of a sudden they come in, they're like, yo, but I'm the King of Pentacles. Like, I can't tell you everything, right? Like, I have to come off a little bit stubborn, you know, a little bit persistent, stable, very focused. You know, I have to have a level of routine. You know this, right? This is what they're saying. And it's also them saying to you, like, you know, right now I'm supposed to play the passive one. You're supposed to come to me, Gemini. And I think because of that, there is an extreme connection or attachment between the two of you. That's what's driving it. It's like you feel it in your body. And how you feel about the Devil is the Ace of Wands. Why? The Three of Cups with the Ace of Swords. You're thinking about when you come back together with them. You're thinking about the what if. Can this really happen? Is there a third party situation? You know, what happens if what this person is offering just isn't enough? Right? Or what happens if what I'm offering isn't enough? Maybe they have other offers on the table that are better than mine, right? I do feel like you've been waiting for something so long from this person, some type of attachment, some type of, how do you explain it where it's like, not necessarily an attachment, but it's almost like a commitment, like a solid commitment that when you're given it, I think that this person is worried if that's what, you know, if you've, you know, you've been waiting for something for so long, that is this enough, right? I feel like that's the situation. Why is Gemini's person of interest? Why are they waiting so long to make that attachment? They're in hermit mode. Okay, why are they in hermit mode when it comes to Gemini? Why? Because of death, they're ending something. What are they ending? The Three of Swords. I don't know, Gemini. I don't know if we did something that was fucked up that hurt their feelings, or if something else happened. Maybe they're trying to end a situation that they're currently in before completely committing to us. And it can be something that we think about, but we're not 100% sure of. But they feel like they have to end that before they can really offer you something. How would Gemini feel about this? You feel like the Queen of Pentacles. Justice, you feel like it's fair. It's almost like you saying, handle your business before you come to me, right? Because that's fair. That's Libra. Do the right thing. Look. Once they do the right thing, what happens? Ten of Cups, King of Wands, okay? Now all of a sudden there's this embrace. It's a warm embrace. It's making you happy. It's giving you, you know, everything that you need, right? Because now finally that they've detached themselves from that person, they can give you that Ace of Cups with that Eight of Wands. That's coming very quickly. You're no longer suspended. You're no longer curious about you know, where the relationship is going. And it's because for them, especially if they want to, or if they view themselves as the emperor, they want to handle their shit first before they come to you. Because for whatever reason, Gemini, and my eyes switching as I'm saying this, we're coming in like we're very, very put together. And that's crazy because for me, as much as people think, and maybe because I'm a Libra rising, like as much as people think I'm put together, like I'm all over the place. Like half the time, like I don't know where my shoes are. You know what I mean? Like I'm very scattered. I have shit everywhere. Like in my head, I have everything going crazy. But this person feels like they need to come at you like an emperor and nothing less, because that's what we deserve. I'm here for it. Yes. Oh, and look, as I'm saying this, I shit you not, okay? Bottom of the deck, we have the ace, the eight of wands. Top of the deck, the all gifted, right? Giving oneself to somebody else. It's like before they can open Pandora's box and make a commitment, right? They have to make sure that they have enough to offer. A caterpillar can't approach a caterpillar cannot approach a butterfly. You don't see butterflies and caterpillars hanging out. So for them, it's like until they can make you a big solid offer, they're not even going to mention it. Now, what's stopping it is obviously either a Pisces or a Cancer or something you don't know. What is hidden here with the moon? Justice. Okay, Libra, what's the energy? How would Gemini feel about justice in the moon? The King of Cups, Scorpio or Leo. I think that you would feel good. I think that you would feel like this person was finally, you know, making a commitment, right? They were finally being the person giving you the love that you've been sitting here thinking about. Four of Wands, Jupiter in Libra, right? It's like this person is finally expressing everything that they've been sitting here thinking about. And it may be something small, right? It may be, I don't know, a song that they send you that explains how they feel, but they do it in a way where you're like, wait a minute, hold on here. What the hell are they trying to say? Because what are they thinking about with the Four of Swords? Watch this. The Ace of Pentacles. What the hell do I offer Gemini? What is good enough that I can offer them? What are they thinking about offering Gemini? They're like, stop asking questions, Whitney. You're being too nosy. What are they offering Gemini here with the Ace of Pentacles? The Hangman, something that we've been waiting for, something that we've sacrificed. What is it? The Six of Pentacles, it's a gift. It's making things right. It's balancing things out. It's doing the right thing. It's taking action on something that we've waited for a period of time. How does Gemini feel about this? The Hierophant, I'm telling you, it's and that's Taurus. It's like we finally have a clear direction on where things are going. How does Gemini's person of interest feel about the block or whatever? The Chariot. They feel like it's forward movement on being stuck in a situation. It's also, you know, where is it going? Six of Swords. It's having an open conversation, an open level of communication on something that didn't make sense. Right? It's having like that aha moment. It's doing something very unpredictable that's not expected. That's Mercury in Aquarius, right? That's having a level of change. But it's also coming from a level of hope, right? It's something that was worked on prior, and now it's something that we have hope in, right? Hope that it's going to come to fruition. So, Gemini, as your outcome, we do have the Two of Wands with the Magician. I do want to say this is beautiful. I love this shit. That's Aries, Gemini, Virgo. Obviously something we've manifested is taking action in physical form. If you want to know more about this, as well as, how does your partner feel about you romantically? What are their intentions moving forward with you? What are they hiding? their next actions, advice, and also the outcome, please feel free to click on the Vimeo. It's in the comment section below. And those of you that this has brought enough clarity, I love you so much, and I'll talk to you later. Peace.